now it's time for our children's story, and Patty is going to be giving us the story. But if the kids would go around and collect those little green flags, and then come up front, and Patty will give the story to you.
Really wanted to go for a long mission trip. And they went several times to Cambodia, and they worked in the refugee camps. What is a refugee camp? Anybody know? Right, right. So people that don't have a home, they can come there from other cities or towns, and they can come and stay in the refugee camp. And so a lot of the people there, a lot of the were children that didn't have homes, and they loved the children. And she said those were the best trips, his wife said that. And they wanted to give all those orphans. Now, what's an orphan? Okay, orphan is someone who doesn't have a mom or a dad. So there were a lot of orphans, and they loved the children, and they wished so much that they could give them all a loving home, but they knew that they couldn't do that, so they decided to provide the best medical care for those kids. And so that's what they did. And Doc Miller always carried peppermint candies in his pocket, and the kids followed him like the Pied Piper, just like our Donald does. But they loved him, and he became known as the candy doctor. So one day, the camp guards called Dr. Miller, and they said, come quick. We need you. There's a young girl and her little brother. They just arrived, and they need some medical help. And so when he got there, he found that the little girl had a broken leg. And she had walked a long distance with that broken leg with her little brother to get to the refugee camp. And of course, the little girl and her little brother caught the attention of the people, and they just loved them. But the little girl was very scared, and her little brother was even more scared. And so doctor fixed her leg. He fixed the broken bone in her leg, and he even used parts from an old car to help stabilize the leg so it would heal properly. And all the while that he's working on her leg, her little brother was hiding underneath her cot because he was so terrified. She had been badly beaten, and I'm sure he had too, and they were very, very afraid. But Doc Miller fixed up his sister, and he hid under the bed. And one day, Doc Miller gave her or came over to the bed, and he gave a present to the little boy. And he gave him a little red fire truck. And the little boy, this little red fire truck, no, I don't want to cry. Okay, so the little red fire truck was just loaded with love. And the little boy took the fire truck and he held it close to his heart. And he dove right back underneath the bed, his sister's bed, and he hid there. So, not long after that, the Millers returned to the United States. And by this time, he'd been retired, and they'd been serving in the mission country for a long time and stuff. And so their son, Gordon, who's also a doctor by this time, decided that he wanted to give his parents a really nice gift. And so he told them, I'm sending you to the Paris Air Show in France. And they were so excited to go, and so they started planning their trip. And however, not long before they left, Doc Miller had a heart attack and he died. And then his wife was like, oh, I can't go, I don't wanna go. I don't wanna go without Dad. And her son Gordon said, but Mom, you need to go. We planned this trip. Dad was so excited to go. Even though he's not here, he would have wanted you to go. So she said, okay. And off they went to Paris, France, to the air show. And when you fly into an airport, there's usually taxis waiting outside. And that's what the case here in Paris. There were all these taxis. And and some of the drivers were outside of their cars, and they saw a driver who looked like he was from Asia. And so she said to her son, if Dad was here, he would want us to choose an Asian driver. to his car, and they got in, and she asked him, where were you raised? And he said, Cambodia. And she said, did you live in one of the refugee camps? He said, yes, my oldest sister was adopted by a French family, but my other sister and I were lost in the camps for several years till she finally found us. And here he was in Paris, France, with the rest of his family. So Wilma was excited. She dug deep in her purse and she found a wrinkled picture of her husband. And she showed it, she put it up there so the taxi driver could see it. And she said, do you know this man? He's my husband, and we worked together in the camps. He was a doctor. He was a very good doctor. And the taxi driver looked at the picture, and he pulled his taxi over to the side of the road. And he said, yes, I knew Dr. Miller. He was my friend. He gave me hope, and he reached under the front seat of his car where he sat, and he pulled out a package, and this is what he pulled out. He pulled out his little red fire truck, a well-worn little red fire truck. And can you imagine how Mrs. Miller felt when she saw that, and her heart was just thrilled? And she said, sometimes she doubted. She didn't know if God had a plan for her, or if what they were doing was always the right thing. And she said, God took me to Paris and showed me a fire truck. And I think we did just what God wanted us to do. Now, each one of you are here for a reason. God put you here for a purpose. And you have no idea, none of us have any idea, how our words and our actions make an impact on somebody else. And a lot of times now, she had to go to Paris to find out that she made a difference in somebody's life. But we might not know till we get to heaven and what our lives have meant to someone else. And I want you to remember this Bible verse. It's Patty's translation. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. Don't trust what you think. In all of your ways, acknowledge Jesus, acknowledge God, and He will direct your path. And you can just trust in God. He's going to lead you where He wants you to go. Okay? So, does anybody want to have a prayer? Anybody? Okay, let's bow our heads and I'll pray. Thank you so much, Lord, for all of your blessings. Thank you for this Sabbath day. Thank you for this story that just thrilled my heart. And thank you for the opportunities that you give to us each day to let our light shine. And I pray that you'll be with us, be with each person here, each child here. Bless them, Lord, as they grow up. Help them to keep their eyes focused on Jesus and let you lead and guide in their lives. In Jesus' name, amen. Oh, that Bible text was Proverbs 3:10.